고나연입니다. 오늘은 제가 지난 시간에 말씀드렸던 특별 게스트 카이오 사멘토 선생님 모시고 오늘 복근분리증에 대해서 알아보고 그리고 복근분리증에 도움되는 운동들 함께 해보도록 하겠습니다. 선생님 모시기 전에요, 제가 카이오 선생님에 대해서 짧게 이제 소개를 해드릴게요. 이 카이오 선생님은 이력이 참 흥미로운데요. 세계 여러 나라에서 물리치료사로서 일을 하셨더라고요. 브라질, 영국, 일본 이 나라들에서 또 환자들 보시고 그리고 이제 미국의 유니버시티 오브 캔사스 메디컬 센터에서 이제 박사학위를 취득하시고 지금 저희 학교 교수로서 또 재직하고 계신데요. 이 선생님이 또 아주 좋은 정보도 많이 알고 계실 것 같아요. 그래서 어머님들에게 도움되는 여러 가지 정보들 함께 알아보도록 하고요. 지금 제가 이렇게 운동복 입고 여기 왔잖아요. 그렇죠? 선생님께서 또 저희 어머님들한테 도움될 수 있는 운동들 가르쳐 주신다고 하니까 어머님들도 이렇게 운동복 입으시고 같이 운동도 함께 해보도록 하겠습니다.
So hello, welcome to our show, and I really appreciate you came here and sharing your knowledge with us.
Oh, hello everyone. Yeah, it's such a great opportunity to be here. I hope this information will be helpful for you. And that's it. So maybe we can just jump to the point.
Jump to the point. I love that. I love this. Okay, so then what is diastasis recti? I know many moms after giving birth and they tend to have their the abdominal muscles, there's some changes in there, right?
Yeah, well, that's a very common condition. So just to talk in a very easy way, we have two muscles right in front of our belly. So it's known as the six pack. So everybody knows about this muscle. Some of you probably already have the six pack. So what happens is that we have a central line between those two muscles. So this central line helps those muscles to keep together. What happens is that, so when you're pregnant, you put too much pressure in this line between those two muscles that they can't hold it anymore. So this line will split up and form a little gap there in this connective tissue.
But I think you explained really well what it is. But is there maybe specific populations or some women tends to have this condition more than others?
Oh yeah, sure. So actually anybody can develop that, even guys. So those guys who like to have this extra beer on the weekends and start to develop a nice, you can develop it also. But yeah, it's much more common in women, particularly over 35 years old. So you're much more at risk if you're older than 35. Other condition is that if you already have one child and you're planning to have the second child in a short period, you're more likely to develop this condition too.
Okay, so that's good. What
So
else? Is this the strength of the muscle, like abdominal muscle, when they were pregnant? Would that also matter for having, diastasis recti later after giving a birth?
that's a very good point because we're going to today we're going to introduce some exercise for you that you can treat this condition. But even more important than treating this condition, you have to prepare to be pregnant. So in other words, if you can gain strength in your core muscles, then it will be much less likely to develop this condition after your pregnancy.
I see. Well, I think that's a really good point. So it sounds like if you want to get pregnant, you want to prepare for it, right?
Exactly, yeah.
And let's say, there are the mothers out there who already have the conditions. Can we have like self-examinations and some exercises can help with the
Yeah,
condition?
absolutely. So first, let's talk about self-examination, and then later we can talk about the exercise. I think the very simple way to test is that maybe I can show it later when we jump to the exercise. So the first thing is that you might feel that your belly is a little bit more projected anteriorly. So it feels that you're still pregnant, there is still a baby inside, because this central line cannot keep up. So your organs inside will not have enough support, so your belly will be projected anteriorly. The second thing that you can do is while you're on the floor, you can squeeze your thumb while you are palpating the central line. So you can palpate along the central line and you might feel a gap. Now, this gap can be, you know, as little as just one finger. So you feel that you can put your finger inside your belly, yeah. But it can be as big, as larger as 3 fingers. Really the best way to get to the diagnosis of this condition is, you know, you go and see your physician or you go and see a physical therapist. But you can absolutely, you know, do a self-evaluation and see if you have this condition.
Okay, I think that's a good point. What about the exercises? Is there any exercise we can do to help mothers?
Yeah, there are a lot of exercise. So we can talk about exercise here for 10 hours if we want. So, but I'm going to tell again, if you have a chance to go to your physical therapist or if you can go to your physician, that's really the best way because the physical therapist will develop a plan according to your condition. So, and everybody might be different. Everybody will be different. So that's really the best way. But there are some like really easy exercise to learn and they are relatively safe. So, and these are the type of exercise that we're going to cover here today.
Before we do exercises or introducing moms, what kind of exercises they can do at home, is there any precautions or like things that we have to you know, be careful before we do any types of exercises?
Well, that's a great point. So most people, they will think, well, no, I just needed to gain strength and I'm just going to do exercise. I will go to Pilates, I will do yoga. Well, you don't really want to be so aggressive in the exercise because the condition can even worsen. So you can develop a herniate mm-hmm. there. So it means that your organs will start to really get out and project into your belly. So that's going to be a very serious condition. And then you're going to need a surgical intervention. So that's why today we're going to start very gentle exercise. But if you keep up with those exercise, eventually you're going to get better. Yes, palpation time. So first thing, let's get to know the muscles that we're talking about. So the very first thing, we're going to palpate the muscles and find the middle line here. So here I can easily find the middle line between those two muscles, between left and right. Now, can I really feel that there's a gap here? I cannot, because I need to engage these muscles in order to feel. So I have the middle line here that are connecting those two muscles, and you lift up your chin, and then you're palpating between those muscles, and you can see how big this gap is. So for her, she doesn't have this condition, so I cannot really, my fingers cannot fit in between those two muscles here. But if you do have this condition, you can fit 2 fingers or even 3 fingers between the muscles. So, the very first exercise, which is the easiest one, but don't get frustrated if you feel it's a little bit of a challenge for you. For some people, it might be a little bit hard, but you're going to get there. So, in this position here, you're going to palpate your hips. Go ahead. Yeah, palpate more or less there. And the aim of this exercise is to make your lower back flat. So, how do you do that? So, you're going to tilt your pelvis. So tilt your pelvis and squeeze your tummy muscles. Yes? So you go up and then go back and relax. Do it one more time. Go all the way and then relax. Now, one important thing about this exercise, some people might use the glutes. So make sure that you're not using your glute muscles. If you feel that you're using your glute muscles and it's hard for you to don't engage them, what you can do is you put your feet together and then you're going to just relax your legs like that and you do the same thing. So yeah, in this way, it's going to be much harder for you to engage your glutes and you're going to be just work on your abs. So you can repeat this exercise for about 10 times. You do it 10 times. And then we're going to relax, have a little break, and repeat 2 more times. So we're going to do 3 sets of 10. We're going to move on to the next exercise. So now you're going to keep in the same position, and you're going to slide one of your legs. So you extend your knee, go all the way, and then come back. And then you go to the next leg. Do the same thing, go all the way, and then come back. Same thing, do it again, go all the way, and come back. So when you're doing that, you can palpate your muscle that you can have some good feedback and feel that you're using, you're engaging your abs. So you do this movement while you're palpating your abs. Perfect. So now, before we move on to the third exercise, we're going to do a little bit of stretching. So you're going to bring your legs, your knees close to your chest, and you're going to hold here. So don't do it too aggressively. So just do slow and gentle and hold your legs. You just hold it for a few seconds. And then after that, you can move left and move it right. So you do a little bit, just a gentle stretching. Yeah. And then you're ready for the next one. So let's put your legs back. Same position as before. So now we're going to do a little bit of a march here. So that's what we're going to do. So you're going to flex one leg in this position and then go back. Once you go back, you move to the other leg and do the same thing. So again, same thing. Keep your hands on your abs so that you're sure that you're engaging your core muscles. Now, if this one is too easy for you, you can do it alternating. So you do one leg. When you're going back, you do the other one. Yeah? And you keep alternating it. So again, just let's make it simple. You just do 10 repetitions. Yeah, good job. Okay, now we're going to do the last one. So you will turn on your belly. Right, this is the position that you start. The very first thing, you bend your knees. Go ahead and flex both of them. And now the aim of the exercise is to lift your belly and to lift your pelvis in the same direction. So in other words, you're going to keep the belly and the pelvis, you try to keep in the same line. So go ahead and lift your belly and pelvis. Yep. And then we're going to keep for 3 seconds in this position. 1, 2, 3. And go down, but very slow. Go down and relax for 3 seconds. Let's do it one more time. Go up. 1, 2, 3. One thing that's important here, so when you're lifting your belly and you're lifting your pelvis, try to keep it in the same line. So as we can see her here, she's dropping her belly a little bit. So I'm going to ask you to, yep, go all the way. Your belly should be in the same line of your pelvis here. So contract your belly here a little bit more. Contract. Yep. So, yep. Now, how do you progress with this exercise? It's very simple. So you just add time on it. So go up again. Go all the way. Instead of 3 seconds now, we count up to 5. And then later on, you're going to keep adding time on it until you get to 10 seconds. So you go all the way, you're going to keep for 10 seconds, and go down and relax. Okay, now, once you're done with the 3 exercises, we're going to do a little bit of cool down here. And this position is known as the cobra position. So instead of staying on your elbows, you're going to stay on your hands. So lift up your body, your upper body. Yes, and then extend your head all the way. Yes, and keep this position for 10 seconds. And lift up your body, stay on your hands and knees. Yep, so that's a very easy cool down. So you're going to just lift your belly up and then go back. Again, lift up and go back. So you can do about 5 repetitions, very slow and very gentle.
여러분 오늘 어떠셨어요? 오늘 선생님 모시고 복근분리증에 대해서도 알아보고 또 도움된 운동들 함께 해봤는데요. 어떠세요? 많이 도움 되셨나요? Well, thank you for coming, and you know we really appreciate what you taught us today. It was very helpful. Is there anything else you want to talk about?
Great. Yeah, I'd like to come back here again and show the progression of the exercise, because I know that some of you already think that's too easy. So we want to come back and show the progression.
Okay.
That's great, because you just promised us you're gonna come back, mm-hmm. right? So I think that's really good. And 어머님들 들으셨죠? 다시 오신대요. 그래서 오늘 배운 운동이 좀 쉽다고 생각되시면은 선생님이 좀 더 어려운 단계, 다음 단계 운동 알려주신다고 하시니까 꼭 구독 눌러주시고 그리고 좋아요 또 눌러주시고 그리고 알람도 설정해주세요. 저는 다음 시간에 또 다른 주제로 여러분과 함께 만나도록 하겠습니다.
안녕히 계세요.
안녕히 계세요.
안녕히 계세요.
Bye.
Bye.